Wes King is a tremendous police officer. He's very dedicated for attending calls for service in our community. He's intelligent and quick thinking. In fact, this is his second Badan Award for saving a life. This little girl might have only had a few more seconds to live. This zip tie was literally squeezing the life from this little girl.
She started freaking out as soon as she realized that it shouldn't be on her neck, and she tried to get it off herself, and in doing that, grabbed the wrong piece of plastic and pulled tighter. I took her in the bedroom and we got a pair of scissors. We couldn't get it cut off because it was too tight and the scissors were too dull. And so we called 911 at that time, and I was just holding on to the plastic as much as I could to sort of give her even a centimeter of air.
Charlotte's mother was doing everything she could. However, she felt helpless. She had no way to cut off that zip tie and save her little girl.
What do I do? How do I make sure that I can keep her alive until somebody gets here? And that's basically all that was going through my head, was what do I do? How do I calm her down? What do I do? Do I have her lying down? Do I keep her sitting up? What's the best way? How do you keep an airway going through when it's being shut off? She just started going more blue and more blue and getting more spots and more spots. And she knew what was happening. She knew. She was like, said, I can't breathe anymore. Mommy, I want to go to sleep. And at that time, that's when the officer came in.
Wes King is a canine officer, and our proximity dispatching by our communications 911 unit allows us to see where every officer is. Luckily, Wes King was only seconds away. Because Wes had those precious few seconds before fire and EMS arrived, he was able to quickly determine the best way to get the zip tie off the young girl's neck. Luckily, our partners from Whoopi Fire had the perfect tool to cut off the zip tie from Charlotte's neck without causing any more serious bodily harm.
And within a second, it was off. She just like popped back to life.
If you could say one thing, anything to that police officer, Wes King, what would you say to him?
Just we were blessed to have him come and help us and thank. We're just so thankful to have her and that. Oh, hello. There he is. Charlotte, remember this guy?
Hey, buddy. How are you?
Hello.
How are you? Good to see you
again.
Good
to see you too.
Things are going okay?
Yeah, things are great.
How are you doing, bud?
Good.
You're good? How's your neck? It's all fixed.
Do you want to finish what you were going to say to me, Tim?
Just thank you so much for coming. And it's your job, but, you know, we saw your face afterwards and it affected you more than words can really say, right?
It did, and I think the big thing for me was that I have a little girl, almost the same age as I told you, as Charlotte, and it was a moment full of obviously a lot of stress and a lot of pressure, but when it all came together, it was a highlight of my career, I can tell you that.
Wow. And to have something around your child's life and your own physical strength and the tools that you have inside of your house to not be able to utilize them, to take that thing off of her, to make her live again. It's the hardest thing that I've had to, deal with in my life. So as of yet, and I've had to deal with a lot of things, your child being so close to you, having to hear her say goodbye, you know, like, I'm going to sleep, mommy. I love you, Charlotte.
Love you too.
It took me a while to sort of be like, okay, we can be normal again, and I don't have to, like, she slept in bed with me for about a month after that. So I just didn't want to let her go, right? It's like piece by piece it keeps sinking in. Every moment, you know, there's many to have until there's not anymore.